So let's see, how do we access the magnetic disks and how long does it take to get to our data? We will assume that the disk is already spinning. If the disk is not spinning, it takes possibly several seconds to actually spin up the disks. So most of the time, if you're accessing our data frequently, the disk will just keep spinning. So if the disk is spinning, then the access time consists of the seek time, which is the time it takes to move the head assembly to the correct cylinder for our data. So we know where the data is, we know which cylinder, which sector, which surface. We first have to get the heads so that they are above the correct cylinder. So at that point, one of the heads will be above the track where our data really is. Next, there is the rotational latency. After we have moved the heads, they're somewhere along the track, but not necessarily, and usually not, above the very sector that we are interested in. So the rotational latency is about waiting for the start of our sector to finally get under the head that will read it. Note that the head is actually sitting in one place at this point, but the platter is rotating, so different parts of the track are getting under the head, and the rotational latency is how long until the beginning of our sector gets under the head. Next, we have the data read, which is we read until the end of the sector is seen by the head. Again, the data read really depends on how fast the disk is spinning and how many sectors we have per track. For example, if the whole track is just one sector, then the data read will be a whole rotation of the disk. If we have 10 sectors per track, then the data read will be 1/10 of a rotation. Then there is some controller time for the disk controller to actually check the checksum, determine that the sector is okay, and so on. And the I/O bus time, which is once the disk drive itself and its controller have the data, how long does it take to actually get that data to the main memory. Now note that unlike a cache or a DRAM, where we could actually be doing multiple accesses potentially at the same time, on a magnetic disk, once we seek to one track, we cannot really be reading the other tracks. So really what happens is accesses to the disk are happening one at a time. We go to a track, possibly read several sectors, but we cannot access another track until we are done with this one and move to the next track. So all of this is the latency to do one disk access, and oftentimes the latency of a disk request made by the operating system includes this plus a significant queuing delay, because we first have to wait for previous accesses to finish doing this, and only then our access can move the heads to the correct position and do a read or a write.